The Attorney General Chiryowa Chiwanuka appeared before the Parliament's Committee on Commission, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises investigating alleged irregularities in the loan agreement that saw Exim Bank of China lend Uganda $200 million. He gave assurance to the public that the airport is secure since Uganda is committed to meeting its loan obligations.
The place of the arbitration is not really what we should be solely interested in. We should be interested in the substance of the dispute. If we are meeting our obligations, we have no doubt that wherever you take us in the world, we'll be able to defend the claim. Obviously, Mr. Chairman, you're correct. The neutrality of the place is important. It gives a sense of comfort to all the parties concerned that if we're in a neutral place, we are likely to get a better reception from the different players.
Social media has been buzzing with reports that the Ugandan government has surrendered the only international airport to China, which would collect revenue to fund the repayment of the loan. The Attorney General told COSASE, chaired by Nakawa West Member of Parliament Joel Senyonyi, that there is no way the airport can be taken over by Exim Bank of China because the loan repayment is supposed to commence on April 1st, 2022.
This contract was signed on 31st March 2015. With a grace period of 7 years, the first payment from Government of Uganda on this contract is supposed to come on 1st April 2022. So, the first payment, yes, the first payment on this contract is 1st April 2022. So for anyone to say that the airport is being taken because of default is absolutely wrong. It is actually scandalous.
If we don't meet our obligation, there are consequences, there are ramifications. Like any other lender, when you go to a bank and you get a loan, if you do not pay that loan, they will take either your land title, your car, or whatever the case might be. The only difference here is that the terms are so bad, they are akin to the money lenders, the loan sharks that we have in Kampala here. The terms are so stringent, so problematic, and that's why we're trying to renegotiate, but China is saying no.
He told the members of parliament that having read through the loan agreement that was approved for signing by his predecessors, he sees nothing that is contrary to the provisions of the Public Finance Management Act 2015.
This is not a dispute between Uganda and China. This is a dispute, this is a transaction between the government of Uganda and the Exim Bank of China. So let us not make it seem like the government of China lent Uganda money. It is the Exim Bank of China that lent the government of Uganda money.
Relatedly, the Chinese ambassador to Uganda, His Excellency Zhang Lizong, has refuted reports that China has taken over Uganda's international airport.
Actually, it's a misunderstanding of the agreement between Exim Bank and the Uganda side. This agreement is actually based, guaranteed by sovereign credit, not by the assets or any assets, including the airport. So it's a misunderstanding of this agreement.
The ambassador was meeting with the Prime Minister, Robin Anabanja, as he handed over a donation of 190 million shillings as relief to the disaster-prone areas.
China and Uganda enjoys a very good friendship. And we have a very good tradition of helping each other during trying times. Like this pandemic, we have helped each other. So the embassy still have some money. We decided to donate this small little money to show our token of friendship, to hopefully this small donation can help those people affected.
Nabanja commended the Chinese government for always standing with Uganda, adding that she will first prioritize Bududa victims who several times have suffered due to landslides.
Inform Your Excellency that this money will be put to good use. It will go to the rightful beneficiaries, the flood victims. And of course, I know through the Minister of Finance, we shall come up with a budget and we shall inform you where that money will have been put.